The decision problem hold always is a fairly natural decision problem, and it's defined as follows. Hold always takes as an input a bit string alpha, which represents a Turing machine. And the result should be 1 if this Turing machine holds on all inputs, and it should be 0 if the Turing machine does not hold on some input. Again, we can use a Cook reduction to prove that this problem hold always is not computable. If we have an Oracle machine with access to an Oracle for the function hold always, we could also compute hold as follows. We simply construct a Turing machine M that always completely ignores its input and then just simulates the machine M alpha on input x. Right? So again, we are given as an input alpha and x, and we construct a machine M that ignores its input and just simulates M alpha on input x. It's important here to note that we construct this machine M, but we don't intend to actually run that machine. We just build the machine. We define what the transition function should be and so on, but we do not run that machine. Instead, we ask the Oracle whether that machine always holds. It's easy to see that the machine will do the same thing for every input. That is because it ignores its input and then just simulates M alpha on X. So it will always do the same thing. And it will not hold if M alpha does not hold on X. And it will hold in all other cases. So if hold always of that machine is true, it means the machine always holds, which in particular means that M alpha holds on X. And so we should return, yes, M alpha does terminate on input X. But if the Oracle returns false and says, no, actually, there is an input for which this machine M does not terminate, it means that the machine doesn't terminate on any input, and it means in particular that the machine M alpha does not terminate when it's given input X. So the right answer here is false. So the answer we should be giving is exactly the answer we get from the Oracle, and so we just return the result that the Oracle gives us for this machine M. We conclude that if we could solve hold always, so we could implement this Oracle, then we could also solve the halting problem, the original halting problem. But we already know that the original halting problem is not decidable, and therefore we conclude that halt always is also not decidable. And that's the entire proof. As you can see, Cook reductions are a very nice way of establishing that something is not decidable, not computable, because we don't need to go through the process of diagonalization every single time we want to have such a proof. We just can use Cook reductions instead, which in many cases is more straightforward and kind of easier to think about. And once again, it all boils down to basically a programming exercise. You want to build an algorithm, write an algorithm that solves this problem halt and can access a sub-procedure for some other problem, in this case, halt always.